greetings. I wanted to offer a little instruction on basic logic. No, really, Islam simply does not prepare people to think and therefore to reason. The following is the first thing to learn. A statement may be either true or it may be false. It cannot be both at the same time. Muhammad was a true prophet from God. That is either true or false. It cannot be both. Muhammad was a false prophet. That is either true or false. It cannot be both. If you have two statements on the same topic and they contradict, there are four cases. Statement 1 is either false or true. Statement 2 is either false or true. There are two cases where one or the other is true. There is a case where both are true. To be logically complete, one must consider the case when both are true. Except remember, you have two statements on the same topic and they contradict. Contradicting means both cannot be true, and therefore this is not a valid situation or logical position, leaving a fourth case to understand. Statement 1 is false and statement 2 is false. Both are false. Most incomplete logic arises from failing to consider all the cases. Let's look at an actual example from Islam's arguments. Statement 1, the Bible is the Word of God. It's true or it's false. Statement 2, the Quran is the Word of Allah. Either true or false. Islam attacks as if there are only two cases. Only the Bible is true, or only the Quran is true. We know logically that both cannot be true, because the Bible and Quran contradict each other. So Islam thinks, attack the Bible and prove it false, and you have therefore proved the Quran true. This is because Islam's thinking is logically incomplete and misses the fourth case. Both are false. The truth of the Bible is independent of the truth of the Quran. Islam attacks the Bible to prove the Bible is false. But proving the Bible false only moves right to left in this matrix. While proving the Quran true requires moving down the logic matrix. So attacking the Bible can never prove the Quran true. But notice something else about this figure. There are two columns. There are two valid cases in column one. But there is only one valid case in column 2. If the Bible is true, it is not even an option for the Quran to be true. Or to be a little more colloquial, if the Bible is true, there is not a snowball's chance in hell that the Quran is true. And that is simply the irrefutable logic of the situation. And that is why Islam must attack the Bible. Muslims fail to understand the logic. And their failure to understand basic logic causes their fundamental confusion about so many topics. May the Spirit of God open your eyes to the light, your ears to the truth, and your heart to His Son, the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.